Previously on AMC's The...
them all to death. Let's make this country great again.
John Donovan and Lincoln Clay embarked on a campaign of urban destruction this country hadn't seen since the Civil War.
Here, over here. This is gonna be... Get out of the water!
I knew it. I can't fucking believe it.
Maybe this will help.
You know how long I've been working with the Marcanos, huh?
Yep.
It took me months to figure out that Lincoln had survived the massacre at Sammy's and was waging a war against Sal Marcano. The Bureau didn't have a file on Clay, and I wasn't aware of his military training because his service records were classified. Otherwise, I might have started to connect the dots after the death of Richard Doucette.
Welcome back to Mafia 3, everybody. I'm gonna go talk to Donovan here.
Tired of getting sand kicked in your face?
Got to do calisthenics 3 times a week. Keep my heart rate up.
You got blood on your shirt.
Cut myself shaving. There's something that you need to hear. Alvarez surfaced. Intercepted this call a little while ago.
I don't understand a word of that. You mind translating?
Basically, you scared the shit out of Alvarez. He's ready to hightail it back to Cuba. Wants his dear Uncle Zaraga to come rescue him.
And what did Zaraga say?
He told him to meet him at the lighthouse on the southern edge of the bayou. He'd send a boat to pick him up.
I'm guessing that was a lie.
Zaraga was a police officer back in Havana when Batista was still running the country. He also provided security for Sal's casinos. The two of them go way back. As soon as Zaraga hung up the phone, he called Sal and told him where he could find his nephew.
Which means I need to get down there before Marcano's men.
Sal's not gonna fuck around when it comes to Alvarez. So make sure your shit's squared away.
Alright, so from the sounds of that, we need to go a little heavier than normal.
I'm running low. Can you send supplies?
We'll get some ammo and get geared up, and then I'll see you guys there. Alright guys, so we're here. I haven't seen anybody just yet. I kind of scouted the area out a little bit. We're supposedly here to save Alvarez, so... okay, there's some people. I'm not expecting much of a firefight or anything going to him, but on the way out I am expecting some heavier resistance. That's usually how these types of missions go.
Fuck! Snakes! You gonna let an itty-bitty moccasin scare you, boy?
They ain't creeping and crawling all up on you.
Just keep your eyes peeled in case this Alvarez guy legs out in this direction.
Alright, so far so good. Looks like just a few more guys left.
Speak for yourself. I get my hands on that little spit fuck.
And you won't do a damn thing. Sal wants his ass alive.
Time to die! Gotta beat him!
Fucked him.
Hold your fire! I'm here to help you!
Come mierda! Vense todo para pinga! Jesus
Christ. You understand English?
See?
I killed the men outside. I only want to talk to you, so I'm gonna put my gun down, alright?
If you try and fuck me, I kill you!
Fair enough.
You You were the one who wants to kill me!
I wasn't trying to kill you, I was trying to find you. Your uncle, he sold you out. He ain't coming to get you.
You're lying! I just spoke to him, he said he was sending a boat.
Wait, you think it's a coincidence that as soon as you got here, those grease balls showed up? Zaraga called Marcano, told him where to find you.
I must find a phone.
Jesus, man, there's no one for you to call. Marcano is never gonna let you out of this city. He's gonna use you, and when he gets what he wants, he's gonna kill you. The only shot at getting out of this alive is me.
What do you want from me?
Tell me where Marcano's counterfeit operation is set up and we're square.
Everything is, in a boxing ring that Tony Marcano owns, but it's already up and running.
Yeah, that's all I need to know. Come on. It's time we got the hell out of here.
Where are you taking me?
I know someone who can get you out of the city. Make sure Marcano doesn't find you.
Yeah.
Yep, called it.
If you want to live through this, stick close to me. You understand?
As I walk along, I wonder what went wrong. Get to my car.
I can get us.
No.
Alright, what's the best way to go here?
Just keep your head down.
I guess we don't really have much of a choice. We have to go the way we came. I think I got that guy in the leg.
Time to fuck you up.
Look at this fucking idiot. And he's dead. Yeah, he's done. Okay. Oh, there he is. I could barely fucking see that guy. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Gotta move up. Holy shit. Nailed him. Had to put that guy out of his misery. Okay. Is there a car? Is there? Yes. Okay. I think. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. That was a pretty nice ride. Mine are better, but you know, it was nice. Why do none of these cars ever fucking start the first time? There we go. Anytime you get into somebody else's car, it never fucking starts up. I think Donovan's was the worst. I sat there turning the key for like a couple minutes. Oh shit. Oh. Yeah. Yeah. Sweet, I don't have to worry about it. This guy's got it. Shit, did they get our tire? Fuck, they have a roadblock. Oh, you dumb fucking truck. If that truck hadn't veered off to the fucking left right there, I could have just smashed through. Stupid fucking asshole. I don't know if I can get through this fucking swamp area. Looks like it connects back over here. Oh, what the fuck? I mean, it's kind of hard on the fucking dirt with the tire shot out and shit, so you can fuck off. Wow, that is a solid bush. Okay. God damn it. Fuck off. How this car is still fucking drivable, I have no goddamn idea.
That was the last of them, I think.
Yeah, well, keep an eye out anyway.
You could have killed me. Put a bullet in my head and still fuck Marcano.
You got a question in there somewhere?
Yeah. Why didn't you?
Just didn't sit right. Look, you didn't do anything to me. As far as I can tell, you're just another person in the long line of folks Marcano's fucked over. Sometimes it's as simple as that.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Lincoln. What's going on?
I need your help getting this man out of the city. He's in a lot of trouble with Sal Marcano.
I don't...
Hit the lepers. This who you told me about?
Yeah, he's the one. Listen, Father, I'm really counting on you here. I got nowhere else I can take him.
Shit, I'm... All right. I know a Jesuit in New Mexico. He helps people in situations like this.
What needs to happen right now? Marcano's gonna tear the city apart looking for him.
All right, I'll make the call. Pasa, por favor. Aquí estás a salvo.
I appreciate this.
Wow, that look on his face. All right, so that takes care of that. Let's see what's next. Oh, time to kill Tommy Marcano. Can we talk to Father James right now? I guess so. Well, let's go do that. We're already here.
I got Alvarez out of the city.
Good.
He told me you saved his life.
All I did was get him away from Marcano's men.
And thank God for that. Let me ask you something. You ever hear how Sal Marcano wound up running this city?
Him and his brothers killed a few guys and took over.
He sold out his own father, Lincoln. Watched him die. And then he killed every man standing in his way. Butchered them. Them and anyone else he thought was a risk, warranted or not.
How do you know that?
Other priests. The sanctity of the confessional isn't always absolute. I'm not an idiot, Lincoln. You're a criminal. Sammy was a criminal. I accepted that a long time ago. But there's a difference between being a criminal and being a Sal Marcano.
I'm not Sal Marcano.
Easy to say that now, but what about when this is over, when there's no one standing in your way?
I haven't decided yet.
You're a good man, Lincoln. I know it's odd to hear that, considering everything you've done. But it's true. You have it in you. I've seen it. But you're gonna have to decide, have to choose, whether you let all of this consume you, pervert you, turn you into the very thing you hate.
Father James always has to say some heavy shit. I'm gonna stop talking to him. He makes me fucking feel bad. Alright, time to go take out Tommy. Yeah, like a fucking boss. All right, talk to Donovan real quick, and then we should be able to go take out Tommy.
Hey there, precious. Got some intel on Twinkle Toes Tommy. Hop in when you're ready.
Well, that was sweet. No one's ever called me precious before.
Tommy Marcano brought in a counterfeiter from Cuba, right?
Well, Sal spent a couple of months trying to print the money himself, but none of it was worth a damn. The color was wrong, printing was cockeyed, you name it. He needed someone who knew what the fuck they were doing. So he used his connections and found a man named Alvarez.
And this Alvarez was also counterfeiting money for Castro.
Most of our enemies counterfeit American money. Hell, some of our allies do too.
Sorry, he's gone.
What do you mean, he's gone? All you had to do is drive down to the goddamn lighthouse and pick him up.
It's not my fault Alvarez is running all over the goddamn place. I wanted to lock his ass up, but you wouldn't hear of it. The last thing we need is Zaraga finding out that we treated his nephew like dog shit. You understand? Then Lincoln Clay comes in shooting the shit out of it.
Lincoln Clay. Lincoln Clay. I'm so sick and fucking tired of hearing about this cocksucker. He's just one man. A fucking nigga. We're skating a thin line here, Tommy. You understand? This thing falls apart. We fucked all of us.
So, what the fuck would you do?
What the fuck would I do?
Listen here. This ain't rocket science. If that fucking nigga got to Alvarez, it means he knows about the plate. He's gonna come after him. You understand? Get your ass down to that motherfucking gym and protect them.
Yeah, sure. I'm on it.
This shit ends right here, right now. No more fuck-ups.
Fuck me.
According to these reports, Tommy Marcano had the money press in a boxing gym he operated.
Tommy knew Lincoln was coming for the plates, but he felt he had to keep up appearances. The second he started canceling fights and shutting the place down was the second people started thinking he was out of his league. He wasn't about to allow that to happen.
How did Lincoln Clay gain access to the gym?
He had me track down a man named Alcee Bennett. Alcee is a small-time hustler that worked for Sammy until he double-crossed him and was kicked out of the Hollow. After that, he scratched out a living recruiting fighters for Tommy's jungle fights. If he vouched for Lincoln at the door, Lincoln could get in without a big ruckus.
Alcee's by the Briar Patch, not far from here. I'll stop by and say hello, see how he's getting along. Have fun.
Oh, I'm coming in hot. Oh. Oh, that guy's dead.
Well, fuck me running. If it ain't Lincoln Clay.
Surprised to see me, Alcee?
I heard about Sammy and Ellis. Tough break. I guess you made it out okay.
Speak of them once more, and I'll slice you from ear to asshole. Let's go. We're taking a drive.
Can you do that to somebody?
What do you think?
Lead the way.
I'm curious how you slice someone from ear to asshole. I need a diagram. I guess we'll take my car. Well, it's not really my car, but mine for now.
You know I'll stay away.
Jesus.
I ain't stepped foot in the Hollow since November.
There we go.
Almost 6 years.
I know.
Can you at least tell me where we're going?
Alright, so it looks like I'm timed on this.
Where Tommy Marcano holds his jungle fights, right?
It is.
And you've been recruiting black fighters for.
Oh, you.
I ain't gonna question your driving, but you might want to pay attention.
Fuck you.
What I was saying was.
Pulled right out in front of me.
Good. Because I want in.
What? Why?
I wanted you to know. I'd have told you.
If I'm sticking my ass out like that, I need to know why.
Motherfucker, you lucky to be alive after what you did to Sammy. You really think he wouldn't notice you stealing all that money?
Look, I paid for that 100 times over. 6 years banished from the only place I ever call home. Christ.
Oh! Fucked.
Where was I? Look, I paid for that 100 times over. 6 years banished from the only place I ever call home. Christ. I couldn't even go see my mama on her deathbed.
You made your choice. Excuse me? And now it's time to make another one.
I'm not good at driving.
You get a clean slate.
I try.
Come and go through the Hollow as you please.
I hit just about fucking everything.
Okay.
I hear if you win out, Tommy meets you in person. That true?
He likes to size up the winners. See if there's someone he wants to bring on regular. Or if they're just a one-time deal.
Where's this happen?
Usually up there in his office. One of his guys will meet you in the locker room after the fight. He'll take you to timing.
Alright, it looks like we're here. Oh.
Hold up, Alcee. Who the fuck's this?
Who the fuck are you? Jackknife Johnson.
Gotta search him. No weapons allowed.
Oh, lol. They fucking locked him out. He's talking to him through the door. Alright, search me. Go ahead.
Do what you gotta do. Watch where you put your hands, motherfucker.
Save it for the ring, dipshit. Go ahead.
Am I about to do some bare-knuckle boxing here? Can I go through the fucking door? Oh, do I need this fucking dipshit with me? And I can't. Oh my god. So dude's locked outside. I need to go forward, but it doesn't look like I can go forward without the guy who's locked outside. And I can't open the door. Oh, fuck. Can I just kill? I can't fight any of these guys. I can't do anything. It's like purgatory. This is fuck bullshit. There we go. Yeah, that was it, because he has to open the door, I bet. Yep. Fucking bullshit. That's twice now on missions that this game's fucked me. Luckily, reloading the checkpoint seems to just fix it, so. Not too big of a deal.
Just dump him in an alley. Let nature take its course.
You good now. Go on.
That's fucked up. And there's a lot of fucking blood. Okay. You just gonna stop and look at that fucking poster?
Where you at, Al C?
Alright.
Someone's got ADD.
Give him your name as such. You go on and get changed.
Oh shit, what's my name again? Jackknife Johnson.
New guy.
New guy looks tough, but my money's staying on the brawler.
I gotta ask you something, Al C.
What's that?
All you niggas love beating the fuck out of each other?
Nah, so what happens if we get caught?
Probably what you think.
For a chance to go home again, it's worth it. No matter what happens, we should go.
Alright, time to go beat some motherfuckers into the dirt.
This is it. You nervous?
Should I be?
Guess that depends on where all this ends. You're gonna head through these doors and then announce your name, then make your way to your corner.
Where are you going?
Oh, I'll meet you there.
So, I wonder if they changed up the fist fighting mechanics for this specific mission, or if it's still just mash B. Oh man, it's fucking dark up in there. Holy shit.
The next challenger to face Nick Boom Boom Beaumont comes in at over 6 feet tall, weighing approximately 220 pounds.
I'm gonna make Nick Boom Boom in his pants. That's such a badass nickname. Nobody wants to fight a guy named Jackknife Johnson. Alright, boom boom, let's fucking go.
Just had to start something.
Come on, bitch. Oh, I missed my opportunity. So it's just more emphasis on the counter system. Oh, dude. Get fucked. I'm coming for that title belt. Is that it? Okay.
Our next fighter hails from Buckley Mills. You'll know him as Bobby Ledoux, the beautiful.
Oh man. That dude's got an ugly mug.
Boom Boom was a paper bag compared to the brawler. You gotta keep moving and don't let him get you in the corner.
Stay out of the corner. Got it.
Come on, bitch.
Fuck him up.
Fucked. I wish we could get like a different ending beatdown execution cinematic thing. Instead of just Link and Clay headbutting them like 3 times in the face.
Making his way to the ring is the Beast of the Bayou, the Rampage of Rivero, your champion, Grave Digger Vaughn!
Grave Digger Vaughn.
You know why?
That's a pretty big dude.
Because he buries motherfuckers?
Well, yeah.
So how do I beat him?
You hit him really, really hard.
Okay. Cool. Good advice. Bro, you're gonna get out of the ring? Oh shit!
Hit him harder! That's it! Get that nigga! Bring that bitch!
Got you in the corner, bitch! Oh fuck.
Yeah.
Bitch.
Fuck him up.
See? Just the headbutts every time. Ugh.
You got knocked the fuck out, man!
It's so brutal, but a little variety would be nice. I don't know, if I paid for that, I feel kind of ripped off. Oh, I can insult the crowd? Yeah. Fuck the crowd.
Trying to start something?
Alright, that's it, kid. Let's go.
What happens now?
You head on back to the locker room and collect your winnings.
Where are you heading?
Me? I got business to attend to.
A 3-round championship fight. I'd feel fucking ripped off.
That's for fucking sure.
You must think
or like a 3-fight card for a championship match.
I've never been one to shy away from a calculated risk.
Maybe you should have.
Whoa, fuck.
I'll mix some vegetable oil in. Mix the gasoline thick. Sticky. We're just gonna let it soak in a little bit. Work his way into every nook and cranny. That way when I light it, that shit's gonna burn like napalm.
Yo, this guy's a fucking twisted cunt.
And you are gonna hurt like no one's hurt before.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Guess you ready to
yeah.
die.
Yeah. Does nobody notice how fast I'm moving my shoulders up and down right now? Oh, yeah.
But as they bind,
oh, God. Fuck you, bro. Come on. Up and down.
Before you die, you gonna feel your pecker burn.
See, I don't know if long, slow strokes are better, or short, quick strokes. Oh, I can hit B there. I maybe need to do that next time. There we go. Oh, fuck! Bitch!
We can work something out.
Only thing needs working out of your funeral arrangements.
Oh man, the Link and Clay one-liners. Almost as good as Schwarzenegger.
So that's that then.
Sure looks that way.
You know Sal wanted me to go to law school. Work for some big company. Maybe run for office. Do something decent with your goddamn life, you understand?
Should've listened to him.
It's in the blood, you know.
Yeah. You are who you are. No point in arguing with yourself about it.
Fuck you.
Are we gonna watch him burn? Okay, I was gonna say, that's fucking hardcore, man.
Don't let me burn. Please.
Don't worry. Lou and Sal will be along shortly.
Punk ass bitch.
No. Fucker's coming for us.
I'm hit. Boy knows how to.
This is gonna be fun.
Fun for me, maybe. Not for you motherfuckers. Got a heal. God, oh fuck. Come on, pop out. Fuck. Smart motherfucker. God damn it. Pussy ass motherfucker, there you go. Oh shit. Oh fuck, I died. I got fucking smoked. That's an awkward position. I probably shouldn't have picked up that AK-47. I should have just whipped out my M1 and kind of roll with that. Oh yeah, he's lit. He's crispy. Yeah, we'll just stick with this. Oh. Oh, nailed him right in the fucking face. Shit. Oh, should not have fucking popped out, dude. Really? Fuck me. Alright, let's try this one more again.
Fucking grenade! Run!
Bitch. Finally. Fuck those guys. Oh shit. Oh fuck. God, I can't see shit. Okay. Oh shit, okay. Nope, need to stay in cover. Oh fuck. Oh, that was a fucking terrible throw. What you wait for? Throw it. Fuck. Jump. Bitch! Where you at, motherfucker? There you are. You just walked through fire? Oh, fuck you. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you.
Eat this asshole!
This guy is in fire right now. Alright, so I'm officially fighting Lucifer and his fucking horde of demons. These guys don't give a shit about fucking anything. Holy fuck. Holy fuck, I'm fucked. Oh god, oh god. Reload faster. There you go. Oh, I'm out of fucking... Run, 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 run. I have no fucking health left. Bitches? Okay. I'm barely fucking making it through this. These guys just have the best fucking accuracy. There's a guy out here somewhere.
Guess that's that then.
Access available, units. Suspicious individual on foot. Officers investigating.
Get in the fucking car, Lincoln.
All units in vicinity be advised. Suspect engaging with on-scene unit.
I'm not engaging. I'm not engaging. I'm just fleeing. You'll never catch me, coppers.
Responding unit.
Nah, fuck.
What happened to the money plates that Sal Marcano stole from the Federal Reserve?
I don't recall.
I understand you supplied the heroin Georgia was selling.
Si. Certo.
I never wanted that in my city. Shit like that fucks with people's heads. Makes them crazy. Stupid. Brings down too much heat. Bourbon?
No, I do not drink.
Georgie, tell you why I wanted to meet.
You said the nigger killed your brother? That you wanted to discuss a deal between the two of us?
My brother Tommy was a smart kid. He could have been anything. I tried to tell him go to college, even offered to pay for it.
I apologize for your loss.
I'm building a casino across the lake. I had it all worked out, including how I was going to pay for it. Now it's all a goddamn mess.
You want my money.
Well, I'm going to need enough to finish the construction. It ain't going
to
be cheap.
I want to hear you say it.
Say what?
That you won my money. Say those words, please.
I want your money.
This is good. Then I will bring you the money, and in exchange, you will let me sell heroin in your city, and you will not interfere in any way.
Sure. Whatever you want. But that's not the only reason.
And you wish me to kill the nigger. I will do that for you as well. I enjoy killing the niggers.
Wow.
Jesus Christ.
That's where Sammy's used to be. No one wanted to live there, so they paved it over. Every now and then, something knocks the hell out of this country. Rattles it so hard, isn't much left but the foundation. And as painful as it is, we hope that this time, things are gonna be different. And that when it's time to rebuild, we won't just repeat what we've done in the past. And that maybe justice and peace will finally prevail. Justice and peace are hard, ain't it? Sometimes too hard. So we take the easy way.
All right, and time for another sit down. This is going to go to Vito. Because he's already got this whole neighborhood locked down anyways.
We're just having a friendly conversation.
South Downs belongs to us. Tommy was smart and set up some solid low-key rackets there. Should be a smooth transition for us.
I heard from my boys before I came over here, and they locked down this turf without any trouble. We're good whichever direction you go here, but we're even better if you make it official and let me call the shots there.
I'm glad to hear we got Marcano's cocksuckers on the run, and I'm willing to look past the fact that you didn't call me about this action if you just give me the turf altogether.
Everybody's got their play, brother. But the truth is that I'm the one you called on to run the last territory. So all that racket shit aside, you know I can handle the day-to-day better than anybody else here.
I get it. You gotta consider all your options.
Yeah, sorry, y'all. It's going to Vito.
Give me the keys to the kingdom.
Ain't a tear.
Make the right choice here, and I'll whip up some fresh Bucatini for you.
So he'll go up to 247, Cassandra will be sitting at 180, and Burke will be at 190. Even though Burke's ahead of Cassandra, I think I'm going to go with Burke on the next one.
Calling this one for Skeletta.
You are one brilliantly decisive motherfucker.
You're just keeping me around here to look pretty. Because right now, I'm struggling to find one goddamn reason to even be here.
So are we done here?
We'll talk later. Get on out of here.
Yeah, Burke's starting to get a little salty, so we'll give him the next one. Alright, but that takes care of that, and then it looks like we just got downtown left, and I guess this last territory. But I appreciate y'all stopping by, and like and subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys on the next one.
Look at this. Somebody come look at this.